Hi, folks. I'm Bob Schrupp, physical therapist.
Brad Heineck, physical therapist.
Together, we are the most famous physical therapists on the internet.
In our opinion, of course, Bob.
Okay, Brad, again, let's just make sure the air is clear here.
Right.
This is not Brad and this is our bike. Brad owns this with his wife.
Right.
Of how many years?
7 years now.
Boy, I'm glad that you knew the answer to that, or you'd be in trouble.
7 years and 3.5 weeks and 2 days.
All right, good that you have the number. Anyway, though, but we thought, we did a video previously on this topic, and we thought, you know, if you're ever considering buying a tandem bike, this would be a good thing, to know some
right.
of these things.
You need to know the things that you must be aware of and probably are not aware of it if you've never had a tandem before or you don't know anybody.
No, this has been surprising to me, Brad, because I didn't know any of these things. So the title of today's program is Tandem Bike, 10 Things You Must Know Before Considering Buying One.
You bet.
And by the way, if you are new to our channel too, please take a second to subscribe to us. We provide videos on how to stay healthy, fit, pain-free, and we upload every day. And also wander on over to Facebook, especially if you're a Facebook
yes.
person. And take a second to like us, because Brad and I, well, what can we say, Brad? Nobody likes us.
Right. Yeah. But we're trying to get over it, and this is helping us. It's part of our therapy.
That's right. Okay.
So first thing, things you must know. You're probably going to wonder how much of these things cost anyways.
Right. I was a little shocked at that one, Brad. I thought they would be less. I don't
know.
But it makes sense once you tell me the reasons why they're more expensive.
Exactly. So this particular bike we purchased used at a bike shop for $1,000.
Quite a few years ago, too, right?
6 years ago.
6 years
mm-hmm.
ago. So.
And I think new, you got to figure between $3,000 and $5,000. You could probably get a cheaper one that does not have the quality of derailleurs. You know, this is a road bike. This bike you could take literally from coast to coast on the United States. You can go thousands of miles on it as long as you maintained it well. It's built that way. There are some other ones that are more recreational, maybe go around the park and stuff, and those are going to get cheaper. And they've got the fat seats, and there's nothing wrong with them, but you're not going to be comfortable on them for
a long distance.
So this is a medium.
And obviously, they don't make as many of these, so that always drives the cost up.
Right.
And the fact that you have a double frame somewhat.
The components are more heavy duty. The brakes are heavier duty. The frame's got to be heavier duty to maintain the weight. So the cost is something you're just going to have to,
You're going to have to pay it.
That's just part of it.
Yeah.
The other thing you have to know is there's the captain and the stoker. Okay, the captain is the captain because they're steering the vessel or the ship or the bike, whatever you want to call it, and the stoker,
is coming along for the ride and maybe providing some engine
right.
power. Right,
as stoker is saying, they stoke the power, and if you really want to get more power, you get the stoker working. But in the case with my wife and I, that happens sometimes. She's actually a good bicycler. She's got strong legs, but she likes to bike and she likes to see what's going on a little bit more.
She's more of a recreational biker at times.
Kind of, yeah. She's between recreational and fitness rider.
Sure.
But anyways, I wanted her to come here, by the way, but she was a little hesitant to get in front of the world on the internet.
we would like to have seen her.
Yeah. So we'll get her here sooner or later. So the thing you must know about the captain is if the captain's personality, you must feel confident in bicycling. So if you're not a previous bicycler, I would not get a tandem.
Really?
Because you're responsible for both people, and they're harder to handle. You'll notice when you turn with these, there's more going on.
Oh, I never even thought about that.
Yeah.
I'll bet you. Do you have to take wider turns probably?
Oh, my gosh. If you turn or do a U-turn in the road, it's a big difference.
Oh, I bet.
You end up going in the ditch and falling over.
Oh, I bet.
Yeah.
I bet. I agree. I can see that happening easy.
We haven't done it yet, but I'm very cautious to make sure we got a lot of room to make a U-turn.
Just even a turn, I imagine.
Right,
it's going to, so like a left-hand turn, you're going to.
Well, not so much just a 90-degree turn, but if you're doing a U-turn. Yeah.
Sure.
It takes a while to get used to. The other thing about, the captain has to be confident. If you're the kind of person that second-guesses yourself, say, we're going to go, oh, we're not going to go, don't be the captain. you've got to either go or not go. It's safer that way. As far as a stoker, if you're a backseat kind of driver, you're not going to get along.
Right.
If the soaker is trying to tell the captain what to do, it's a good way to cause problems.
So, Brad, tell what happened to the couple that you bought this bike from.
Well, like I said in the other video, you know, a tandem can either make a relationship stronger or it can
break it apart.
Yeah, and this is from a couple. They were either divorced or they were
on their way.
Well, I don't know if they're actually married, but it was a couple that had been together, but they're not anymore, and they got rid of their bike, so we got a good deal.
Yeah, sure. And you're still together after 6 years, so it must have been a good
deal.
Right,
yeah. We work really well. We haven't had any problems on it, and we haven't tipped over yet, which is another point. If you're going to get a tandem, and we got clips on ours, but I would never ever recommend anybody to go with clips unless you're very good with clips.
Yeah.
So get flats, get some flat pedals, because
tell them what clips are, Brad. People don't know. People don't know what clips are.
The clips are so your feet literally clamp into the pedal.
So you have a shoe design that actually clips into the pedal.
Right. And you use them because you're much more efficient with them.
Yeah, because you're pulling up and pushing down.
Right. So any bicyclist that is a serious bicycler understands that. If you're not, that's something new. Then you're going to get flats, and there's no
question. And
that's
what I have. And when Brad told me that when you get clips, either you've fallen down with a bike or you will fall down eventually.
Yeah, sooner or later you're going to fall. We have not fallen yet.
I'm old and I don't want to fall, so I didn't get clips.
Right, so you get flats to start out with. The other thing is the sizing the bike to the person is critical. Bob is 6.5 foot tall. I got to be honest, it would be hard. I think you would have to get a pretty expensive bike to get a bike to fit you. How tall is your wife?
She's 5'9".
She's a little taller, maybe. I mean, I'm 5'10", my wife is 5'6". There isn't much difference there. But you have to get the frame size that fits the person. So that can be a big game changer, particularly on a used bike. You get a new one, they're going to order from the factory to fit you. You get a used one, you're stuck with what you got. And hopefully you can raise the seat up and down and the handlebars, because there's different variables on handlebars on these. I've got the handlebars in front raised way high because it's better on my back.
Yeah.
But there's a lot of variables that you may not be aware of before, you know, buying one, if you haven't thought about that. So the fit's important. Education. What we did with this bike is we were advised by the seller, which was a bike shop. They gave us a book. We bought a book, and we both read the book on how to ride a tandem.
Oh, good idea!
It was worth it. My wife actually read it twice, once for me and once for her. Well, actually,
how that marriage works.
I did read it, but not as detailed as hers. But it gave us some good hints on bikes, on a tandem,
and even
things you got to expect.
Signaling each other.
Yep, signaling, safety. Like, we do have a mirror here. This is a nice mirror, so that my wife. Her job is to see what's coming behind us. My job is to see what's going on in front. And so she uses this mirror. And what she does, or is supposed to do, if there's a car coming, she's supposed to tap me on the butt right there. Once for one car, twice for two cars, three times means we're going to stop and go in the woods. Just kidding. It's a family show, Bob.
Wow. That one took me by surprise, Brad. So.
And the other thing is, if you're going to fall on these, almost for sure, not almost for sure, but likely is you're going to do it when you're starting or stopping.
Oh, sure. You're slowing down and you're...
Well, the thing is, you're sitting on here and then you got to decide. Both people have to start at the same time to go. So our system is, my wife and I say 1, 2, 3, go.
Okay.
And we both have to be ready. I've got my hands where they need to be. We put the pedal at the 9 o'clock position here, so we're both pushing down and everything syncs up. And then when you stop, you have to put the same foot down. If I put my right foot down, she puts her left foot down, it gets really wobbly.
No kidding.
Oh, yeah. Wow. At a stoplight or a stop flashing, you know, light, and you put your foot down.
There are things you don't
know.
And
you tip over on one of these, it's really embarrassing.
I would not know that.
And it can be dangerous. So starting and stopping is a big factor on getting to know each other.
So this is not an easy thing to even to rent.
No, you know. No, it's not. But if you've never ridden one, you're going, let's go rent the tandem, bicycle built for two.
Yeah.
We'll sing the song.
Right.
You'll get on it, and you'll start taking off, and you might be hollering at each other.
Sure.
You'll be singing a different song besides bicycle built for two. Oh, a big safety thing.
Good luck,
everyone. I'll get out of the way here.
I got to show you this. If you live around hills like we do in La Crosse area, can you zoom right in on this? The normal brakes are here on a bike, most bikes. This is a something, got that, Lonnie? This is called a static brake. When I go like that, you see it doesn't spring back. These will spring back. I don't have that one connected, but these will spring back. This one does not, it's static. It goes to the back, there's a drum brake in the back, and if I got a steep hill we're gonna go down, you will really go fast on a tandem. You'll easily pass any single rider bicycle, but on a tandem, because you got twice as much weight because of the body weight, and only half the resistance because you only got one body, and so the wind resistance.
Tell them how fast you were going one time, Brad.
Once we got up to 48 miles an hour, I didn't have this.
That's fast on a bike.
Well, we were racing.
Sure.
And I was racing. My wife, she actually is very good. She trusts me a lot. She was not scared yet, but I was. I was like, oh my gosh. So I start hitting the static brake because these brakes don't, they may fail if you're going that fast and something goes wrong. So the static brake, you hit it at the top of the hill, and I like to keep around 30 miles an hour going down a hill. I feel quite comfortable.
That's fast.
No, if you ride a lot, it's
not.
Around here, you know, the hills, you'll feel pretty comfortable. At least I do, my wife does. But when I get up above 40, 45, I'm a little uncomfortable. So the static brake, you put at the top of the hill, and you just maintain your speed, 25, 30, whatever you want, and you don't have to put these brakes. It's a great device. Tandems, if you got hills, get a static brake. It's worth every bit of the money for safety and keep your nerves and everything intact.
They don't make static brakes for regular bikes, or do they?
I don't know. I don't. Not that I'm aware. I think you could put one on it, but you have to give the drum brake in the back. One more point. On the tandem, the person in the back over bumps is a lot more rough because the length of the wheelbase center to center. Back here, the bumps are a lot more aggressive than here because you're bouncing higher if you think about it going like this. So if you look right here, there's a little cushion. So this seat actually has got a shock absorber in it.
Now, you had to buy that special, I imagine.
Well, it came with the bike.
It did.
Right, yeah.
They knew that.
Right.
They knew that. Right. Okay.